many basic aspects that as an entrepreneur, why at all we need to look at for this marketing aspect, or why we need to learn about the marketing knowledge, or why we need to, you know, apply this marketing knowledge. So basic thing comes that when actually you are into a business or you are about to be in a business which includes some new idea, some new product or some new concept, then it becomes very important to understand that how to go to the customer, what mechanism you should adapt to go to customer, and at the same time how to, you know, proceed to introduce your product into the market, what media you should choose. So okay, let me explain a different way. Say for example, you know, what exactly marketing is. If you are already in the market, that means your product is already into the market, then it becomes really important to learn that what is your product performance. That product performance depends that how much, you know, movement of product from company to, you know, customer or market is there. That means flow of product. Then we need to learn that, you know, what exactly marketing is. Then you can understand how can, you know, control, how can regulate, how can maintain this product. You know, what is marketing? If you look at that marketing aspect, you will come to know that marketing is nothing but simply, you know, assessment of the, you know, customer need, converting that need into product or services, and then providing to the customer to satisfy that need that you have ascertained. And in that case, it becomes very crucial and very important to understand that, you know, what, how to ascertain need of customer, how customer is thinking. So it is important to learn that, you know, who is your customer. Marketing is basically from customer point of view. If you try to learn, marketing is nothing but simply getting the right product at the right price at the right place through right promotion. Now you need to understand all these right P. Right product, right price, right place, right promotion. These four P are called as a marketing mix. Now for a new businessman or for a startup, you must understand what is the, you know, first P, product. Product is basically, for a startup, product is just a conversion of your newer idea, new idea. And with respect to that new idea, you need to search a new customer, because your idea is new to the market, new to the customer, new to the world. So in that case, it becomes important to look at that product variable. Product variable means whether product serves the, you know, gap available in the market, demand in the market, customer need, customer expectation, or the idea that you have innovated, whether that idea is based on the genuine problem in the market or not. And if it is so, then it will be very, very easy for you to go with, you know, marketing of your product. That means product variable must be very clearly understood. Second point is important, the price. When your new product is coming to the market, you must understand what price you should fix. in fixing the price or in the pricing policy, you must understand whether your customer is, you know, coming from lower class, middle class, or higher class. If your customer is coming from lower class, so obviously you will think to put your product cost or service cost, you know, as lower as possible, because your customer is very much concerned about the price. Lower class customer is price conscious. So in that case, you must put your price of the product lower side in the market. If your customer is coming from higher class, obviously you know that higher class is quality conscious, not the price conscious. So since higher class is quality conscious, so your focus should be on quality and price is not a matter. So you can put your price in the market as a highest one, but the customer is not going to compromise with the quality. So in that case, it becomes evident that, you know, for lower class and higher class, the price and the quality factors are very common. But in case of middle class, you know, middle class is very much concerned about the price as well as quality. Middle class wants the best quality in the best price. So for middle class, you need to, you know, look at the price aspect also and the quality aspect also. And in that case, a balance or a very, you know, strategic approach must be followed in putting price of the particular product or your new idea or service. For example, you can understand when you know, MI phones came into the Indian market, they had a sort of low cost means as compared with, when you compare with available product in the market. On other side, OnePlus came into the market with the higher price. So when you put your you know, product cost lowest in the market, this is called usually penetration policy, penetration strategy in pricing. But when you put your price of the product highest in the market or higher side, it is called skimming policy of pricing. So skimming policy simply aims to take most of the cream of the market, and lower class try to, you know, take or attract the maximum number of customers out of the market. So pricing policy is to be looked into very important, you know, manner. Another important P which is crucial is that place. Again, as a four P of your marketing, I say that first P is product variables, second P is price, third P is place, and fourth P is promotion. Marketing is nothing but the four P. The marketing mix includes four P, and as a function, you must understand all these four P and how to manage and how to, you know, decide about these four P's and related aspects. Third P is place. Place means the place of distribution, the distribution channel, the logistic, the supply chain, the, you know, the, if you look at that overall place of distribution or distribution system, you can understand that one method is very common, like direct marketing, what you understand, network marketing, what is called like MV type of, you know, distribution system. The second type is traditional distribution system, means you appoint a wholesaler and then retailer and then shopkeepers and all. In last one decade, another mod is emerged, online market, where you don't have to put your wholesaler retailers, but only the thing is that you can sell through online and you use your own logistic and supply or the services of marketplace like Amazon and Flipkart. So through online you can sell your product. So in that case you need to decide that by looking at the characteristic, the type of product and all these things, you as a entrepreneur or as a businessman, you must decide whether to go for online or go for offline or go for network marketing distribution system or adapt traditional one, wholesaler, retailer, shopkeepers and all. In this decision, the characteristic, the nature and the type of product is also very important to look at. Say for example, if it is any kind of product which is to be looked at grocery shop, say for example biscuits, say for example any other grocery product, that has to be made available at Nukkad shop or any grocery shop. The customer is not interested to take pain to go to 5 kilometers and 10 kilometers to purchase that biscuit. Instead of going to 5 kilometers, the customer will change brand and customer will not purchase the loyal brand and go to next one. But in case of the slow moving consumer goods like cars, customer can go to 10 kilometers. In case of some of the luxury or precious items, the customer can go to another district also. Say for example, the Bosch company is having only one two retail outlets, company showrooms in UP sort of thing, or in all over India you will find very less number of retailing. Earlier when Audi and Mercedes, they launched their car in India, they had very few retailers when you compare with the car market. Like Maruti and Hyundai, usually they have 2-3 distributors in city. But in case of Audi, you may find that someone is there in Lucknow or someone is there in Kanpur and not in nearby other B or C grade cities. So in that case, it is important to understand one mode of distribution of product, and this mode of distribution depends on the nature of the product. So when you are introducing any new product into the market, you must understand whether you go for online or offline. Another important aspect about the consumer behavior nowadays is that if you say that we'll only go by online distribution system, you may not be successful. And on the other side, if you decide that you will go only offline, you may not be successful. The examples are evident. When MI introduced their phone, they started with the flash sale and they started with the online platform, and at that point of time there was no wholesaler, retailer or shopkeeper or showroom in local cities. But after some point of time they felt that they should have offline channel also to distribute product. They adapted and they started their offline showrooms in different cross cities, B or C grade cities, to cater the need of or to penetrate the market in C grade cities or B grade cities. On other side, Samsung, which was previously believing only in offline sale, and after so many years feeling that they felt that only offline cannot, you know, be a good idea, and they entered into online also. So what is the logic behind this? You know, nowadays consumer behavior is changing in a different way. Sometimes consumer, you know, research online, purchase offline. Sometimes some customers are there who research offline and purchase online. So it simply means that to cater the need of, you know, customers, either you understand that which customer is researching online and purchasing offline, or researching offline or purchasing online, you must, you know, follow both the channels so that the customer gets information and everything on both the channels, online and offline. So this has given new challenge to newer you know, businesses, and even the existing businesses also. The fourth P, which is still very important and, you know, good, is promotion. Promotion mix, or promotion, usually we also call it the promotion mix, which includes number one, advertising, number two, sales promotion, number three, personal selling, number four, publicity. So these four are the important tools of promotion, fourth P. Taking first, advertising. Now, advertising is basically, you know, you need to understand that what is advertising. It is basically a paid form of promotion using some media. So paid form of means you are bearing some cost, and then you are designing advertisement and using some media and then floating it. It is simply creating awareness about the product among the customer and then motivating them to purchase. So advertising is very important to understand in this advertising, whether to choose for print media or choose for electronic media. That depends on your customer. Where is your customer? To understand this advertisement or promotion, obviously promotion means promote your product to your customer. To your customer means you know your customer. To know your customer means to know their, you know, availability, their reach, their channel, their connectivity with you. So if your customer read you know, Dainik Jagran newspaper, so give advertisement in Dainik Jagran. If your customer study, you know online CNN news channel or New York Times, or you follow. If your customers see Al Jazeera, so you go to advertisement in Al Jazeera. So to give advertisement in Al Jazeera, you must know your customer. That customer is seeing Al Jazeera. So you have to track down the customer, that which channel customer is following, and accordingly you need to choose the media. And then also important, how effective your advertisement would be. I'm not going into that, you know, detailed theory of advertisement. That is another, you know, full length domain of knowledge. But yes, when you talk about that, you know, advertisement, the important thing comes that how to choose media, even in digital media, even in that media, how to choose it. Usually nowadays there is a game of TRP. The high TRP, they have different rates of advertisement per slot, maybe 10 seconds or 5 seconds or 15 seconds. In some internet media, you may have different rates. In your print media, you may have different rates. So what is mechanism, that is also important. And then it comes that how to develop advertisement. This is another industry. Usually the creators and developers, they are called as advertising gurus, because they create some new virtual sort of story or promotion advertisement by which the most of the customers are influenced and affected, and they impact directly on sale of the particular company. So in that advertisement, it is important that who is attached with, like, celebrity. Sometimes Amitabh Bachchan come into advertisement and effectiveness increases, your sale increases. If you go with the Nawazuddin Siddiqui, your advertisement may be effective in some class. If you go with some Hindu priest, that will be effective in some class. Say, for example, for promoting nowadays safety and security, or you can say the health consciousness, the government is taking help of all these religious gurus. Some Muslim clerics are coming to give their message. Some Hindu priests are coming to give their message that be safe, make social distancing. So government is taking help of these people. Why? Because they have mass reach, they have mass effect, they have mass impact. And that is why you use celebrities in your advertisement. When Amitabh Bachchan comes into Pulse Polio advertisement, the effect of that advertisement, goes multiple times, increases multiple times. So it is important to understand about the advertising game, advertising theories. Second is sales promotion. Sales promotion means, sales promotion includes the tools like POS, point on sale, the discounts, the offers, the sponsoring events. These are some tools of sales promotions which directly affect the sales promotion. And company must understand when to give offer, when to give discount, when to sponsor a particular event or not to sponsor a particular event. So as a new startup, you may not be capable enough to promote your product with the sales promotion by giving discount or offers. It's very difficult because you don't have capability, financial capability of that. You may not have that financial capability to sponsor events. But yes, to some extent, 5-10% you can do it. Because nowadays, if you don't make showbiz, customers are not going to purchase. So little bit, show is important. Then third point comes personal selling. As a new startup or as a new businessman, you must understand the strength of this personal selling. Because initially you may not have that financial capabilities to go for any professional agency to hire and give advertisement in this channel and that channel. So you may have a very basic of your personal selling. You may contact customers one to one. For example, when Nirma started selling detergent powder. So he was putting some kgs of detergent powder on the carrier of a cycle and selling in Ahmedabad. Those very narrow gullies, and right morning to evening he was moving on cycle, and night he was preparing those he was producing those detergent powders. So initially personal selling. So for a startup or new, personal selling is having very one thing, cost effective. It is not involving much more cost. Second thing is that it is, you come in personal touch, direct one to one. So while you talk to customer, you can understand their response, feedback, everything. So it is very good tool. Fourth is publicity. Publicity is again very important because you must understand how to publicize this particular product. But there is a difference in publicity and advertisement. publicity is a kind of advertisement, but the non-paid form of advertisement is called publicity. Non-paid means no cost involvement in publicizing. So whichever mechanism you follow to publicize your product, but learn the negative side that you do not have control on negative. You do not have control on stopping that publicity if it goes in negative way. Because you give some message, but next person changes that message. Say for example, if you want to publicize yourself in your college, so it is very easy. Go to your departmental building and take a jump from third floor. You'll be publicized across the college. And then this publicity would be uncontrolled. Uncontrolled means some student would be talking that the fellow has taken this step. Because of that love affair. Another story may be planted that because of the study pressure that person has taken this drastic step. So n number of stories will come into the market when you follow publicity. So how to stop those stories? So that is uncontrolled, and that is why publicity is considered as a double-edged weapon. So you must not follow.